And then mute.
Just to recap, we opened this meeting for purpose of a zoning commission interviews, president or trustees Asherel and Sweattick, and a motion to go into executive session to consider employment for zoning commission. And the trustees both voted affirmatively. And now we will go into executive session. Thank you.
Okay, at this time, I'd like to make a motion to adjourn executive session at 7:47 p.m. Do you mind if I borrow this?
Second.
Seconded by Astral. And we're going to go through a roll call. Astral?
Yes.
Swedick?
Yes.
Augustine is a yes. Okay. All right. I missed the first two interviews just for the public to know. I have interviewed these two folks countless other times. They're always fun to interview. Does this board feel comfortable making a decision this evening?
Yes.
I believe so.
Okay. And what are your thoughts on the candidates?
I think the my clear choice is to go with Cindy Engelman, our existing alternate. She's been on the board for a year now. She's very knowledgeable. She does her research. She has a great background, legal background, which is, you know, something that was asked of in there. I just think she would be a really good fit, and she was highly recommended by, was it everyone on the zoning board? Definitely.
I believe so.
Definitely Bill.
Yeah.
Recommended her.
Okay. I would echo those thoughts. I think if some of these other folks, maybe alternate, it would be a good choice for them to get their feet wet. With Cindy being there as the alternate right now, I think she has a pretty good background, and with everything else that Monique added in there, that I think she would have my vote.
Okay. So with that said, we have another decision to make, because then that opens up the alternate position. So one of the things that Bill Spellman had mentioned in his letter recommending Cindy is that he would be willing to carry on in an alternate position because he couldn't commit to the five-year term. Would you be comfortable in swapping them and putting Bill Spellman on as the alternate, since he has had over 10 years experience with the board? And I think really grew to have a great working relationship with this board.
Well, what you've been saying all along is there's no vacancy. There won't be a vacancy until January, so we can't fill that role.
If you make a motion right now for Cindy to become the member as of January 1, then you've created a vacancy that would allow Bill to be the alternate.
I'm not sure about that right now. I would have to think about that, because to Jack's point, I think we just interviewed a couple other people that, you know,
had I don't an think interest in any one of these people have as much experience as Bill Spellman or the working relationship that he has.
I'm with not the saying that, but for me, my point would be is to build somebody else, build a knowledge base there that they will be able to move into one of these positions if we lose another board member.
I understand that, but we're citing the rationale for bringing Cindy on. She's only been on for a year, and I'm not saying that's not a long time, but it's not a long time at the same time. And you've got Bill Spellman, who recommended her, which is your rationale for moving her up. Mm-hmm. In addition to her experience.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And I think that that's a really good swap, because Bill has the same thing. He has a group of people that have supported him that would like to see.
No, I'm not discounting that. I understand. And I would love to have him, but I'm talking about building a bench. So, because he will obviously not move up if we lose another board member, he's already stepped down from the current position.
I think we have a very young board. Marcus has only been with us for a couple years. Michelle Crew has only been with us for a couple years. The most senior person on the board is Matt Marzullo.
Can we talk to him first before?
He already said in the letter that he would be interested in the alternate position.
But I would like to ask him a few questions.
And also I wanted to ask you both your thoughts on, you know, we decided at the beginning of the year that we were only going to go with one alternate. And I wanted to know your thoughts on going to two, because we did have that weird meeting where we didn't have a voting member and we didn't have our alternate.
We still had a quorum.
But we did not have our alternate or a full voting member. So
have there historically been more than one alternate?
Yeah.
There were two alternates, but it's not necessary. According to Ohio Revised Code, we only need one. So what we did was we reduced it to one because our zoning budget does not really support two. We thought we might see a better funding for the zoning lines if we didn't have a full board. So we figured we would try it. And I think we were successful with it.
We were. To remind you, Jack, we went to one alternate in January or February because we weren't having enough people apply. That's why we went to.
That is not why. The reason why, and I said it publicly, was because we wanted to reduce the funds out of the zoning.
There also were not enough people applying, and that is why we decided to only have a single person, a single alternate. If not, we would have had to extend the time to apply because we did not have enough. So I'm just saying, do we want to discuss this, bringing back a second alternate, which we have had in the past, we had just last year, because we did run into that exact.
We didn't run into any problems. We had a quorum and we were fine. I think that one alternate worked out really well.
I feel like it's semantics.
I think you're pushing right now.
I feel like it's semantics right now of we may have had a quorum, but how many times have we heard Melissa Augustine say a full board is the happy board? We didn't have a full board. We didn't have that full board that day.
A full board is the most efficient for board, but the Ohio Revised Code says 5 members, 1 alternate is all that's needed. That's a full board.
Okay, let's do this.
You know what? I'm not comfortable making a decision tonight now that we've had this conversation with regard to the zoning member.
Okay, we can make it on the
because client. I think you're vying for Nikki Long because she's a friend of yours. That's why you want
that. I think that's highly inappropriate.
I think that's
exactly that is highly inappropriate. And I have not even said
that's why her pictures are on our website.
What?
The pictures that are on our website of the houses. Those are her pictures. We have all of this conflict and I'm not comfortable with that.
Melissa, the pictures that are on the website were taken from a professional photographer that were put on our website. I'm sorry. I'm not even going to talk about this anymore because that's petty and that has nothing to do with this decision.
I make a motion to appoint Cindy Engelman to the full voting member position on the zoning board.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
No. And the only reason I won't support it is because if you're going to support that with the rationale you have, then you would put Bill Spellman into the alternate position.
Well, it passed, and we will look at the alternate position in the coming weeks.
So if I make a motion right now for Bill Spellman, you're not going to support it?
Not right now. I told you I would like to ask a few questions.
At this time, I'd like to make a motion to adjourn at 7:55 p.m.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
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 Have a good night.
You too.